good day. We are pharmacy students from our Lady of Fatima University, Quezon City campus. The presenters are Ms. Justin J. Del Rosario and Ms. Royce Ann Alizaban.
In vivo determination of the laxative property of syrup with semi-purified anthraquinone from the crude leaf extract of Sesbania grandiflora, also known as Katurai on Rattus norvegicus or Sprague-Dawley rats.
Introduction. Let's first define what is constipation. Constipation is broadly defined as the unsatisfactory defecation characterized by infrequent stools, difficult passage, or both. Laxatives, also known as purgatives or aperients, are used as a treatment and prevention for constipation. Sesbania grandiflora is native to Asia and is now widely spread to tropical regions of the world, such as Philippines. Statement of the problem sought to answer the following questions. What are the phytochemical constituent and functional groups present? At what concentration does the semi-purified anthraquinone from the crude leaf extract elicits its toxic effect and highest laxative effect? For the 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th, the question sought to answer if there is a significant difference among the groups of the positive control, negative control, the experimental groups, and the formulated serum. Hypothesis of the study. The null hypothesizes that there is no significant differences among the said groups. In contrast, the alternative hypothesizes that there is a significant differences among the groups. Assumptions. The researchers of this study aims to prove that there is a laxative property obtainable from the crude leaf extract of Sesbania grandiflora by means of semi-purification process, acute toxicity testing, and biological testing. In addition, formulated syrup will be used as an alternative preparation for constipation. Significance of the study benefits the following: the manufacturing firms, the patients, the community, the field, and the future researchers. Scope and limitation. The study of Sesbania grandiflora was limited only to its laxative property and not by its other uses. Semi-purification process is done at the University of the Philippines, Manila by Mr. Paolo Bueno of the Department of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology. Biological testing was done at the JPET Master Animal Diagnostic Laboratory at Visayas Avenue, Quezon City. Formulation and product development was done at Our Lady of Fatima University Pharmacy Laboratory. Methodology. Let's start with a collection of the plant sample. Sesbania grandiflora leaves was collected at Guadalupe Subdivision, Calaocan City. It was washed, air-dried, pulverized, macerated, and semi-purified, followed by acute toxicity testing, biological testing, preparation of the syrup, biological testing using the formulated syrup, gastrointestinal motility, statistical analysis results, and determination of the laxative property. For the acute toxicity testing, we follow the OECD 423 guideline. Acute toxicity test is done within 24 hours with fractionated time, having four groups, with a starting doses of 50, 100, and 200 mg per kilogram with their respective weights. 600 mg per kilogram is declared as the toxic dose and 1,800 mg as the lethal dose. Biological testing. In the first week of biological testing, the animals undergone the induction of constipation using 1 ml of loperamide, except the normal group. Biological testing composed of 3 rats each group. The groups are group 1, negative MSS with a dose of 1 ml per kilogram, group 2, constipated MSS with 1 ml per kilogram, group 3, the constipated lilac receives 300 mg per kilogram, group 4, the constipated which receives 300 mg per kilogram, group 5, constipated which receives 400 mg per kilogram, and last, the constipated which receives 500 mg per kilogram semi-purified anthraquinone from the crude leaf extract of Sesbania grandiflora. On the 7th day, gastro the normal saline, positive control, the high elicitic semi-purified, and the formulated serum. The gastrointestinal test was done to determine the movement of the intestine, having the formula of the distance traveled by the charcoal meal over the total length of the small intestine times 100. Laxative activity test. The administration happens in 7 days. So was the fecal parameters, namely the number of fecal pellets, weight of wet and dry, and water content. The water content has the formula of wet weight minus dried weight all over wet weight times 100. Formulation. We started with the preparation of the simple serum composing of sucrose and distilled water. Then, the preparation of the laxative serum. We used the 500 mg per kilogram in the semi-purified anthraquinone as our active pharmaceutical ingredient, adding sodium benzoate, sodium carboxymethylcellulose, and the simple serum prepared previously. The formulated syrup also undergone the laxative activity testing, composing of 3 constipated rats, and the determination of the fecal parameters. The formulated syrup group also undergone the GI motility testing. Results and discussions. These are the results of argon electric evaluation of ethanolic extract, semi-purified anthraquinone, and the formulated syrup. For the phytochemical screening results, we have anthraquinones, saponins, tannins, and steroids. For the formulated syrup, we tested its viscosity, and its result is 14 millipascals per second. And for the pH, we have 6.06. For the FTIR results, we have alkanes, alkenes, carbonyl, aromatic compounds, ketones, acid, amides, and alkylates. These functional groups could possibly be used as reference for specific anthraquinones. For the result of the fecal parameters, the fecal parameters have the values expressed as the mean and the standard deviation on the 7 days collection. We have graphical representation of those parameters, namely the number of feces, weight of wet feces, weight of dry feces, and the water content. These are the graphical representations of the parameters. We have 4 parameters, namely the number of feces, weight of wet and dry feces, and the water content. As we can see, the lilac, which is the positive control, gives and elicits the highest laxative effect, followed by our 500 mg extract and the formulated syrup. Graphical comparison between the semi-purified anthraquinone with 500 mg per kilogram dose and the semi-purified anthraquinone formulated with syrup. As we can see, we have minimal differences on the statistical analysis. For the comparison between the constipated and the formulated syrup, there is insignificant difference on their number of feces, weight of wet, number of dry, and the water content. For the positive control, which is lactulose, in the formulated syrup, there is also minimal differences between those groups. Comparison of the gastrointestinal motility test, we have the percentage of distance traveled, and our positive control, which is lactulose, and is its highest distance traveled. Conclusion. The conclusion answers the research questions. Number one, we have what's the phytochemical constituents? The answers are saponins, tannins, steroids, and terpenoids, and anthraquinone. For the functional group, we have carbonyl, alkenes, and others. For the toxic effect, we have 600 mg per kilogram. And for the laxative effect, we have 500 mg per kilogram. It is the highest laxative effect among the 3 concentrations of 300 mg and 400 mg. We have the negative control and the semi-purified anthraquinone. They show significant difference. For the semi-purified anthraquinone, 500 mg and the formulated syrup, we have no significant difference. And for the positive control and experimental control, we have significant differences. And for the constipated negative control and the formulated syrup, we have significant differences. solution. The characterization and identification of the anthraquinones present at the Sesbania grandiflora. And we also recommend the use of other equipments to isolate the anthraquinone. The future researchers may also conduct other tests to reveal its adverse effect. And the researchers believe that Sesbania grandiflora has other therapeutic effects. So, further study of its properties is recommended.
For the acknowledgement, we would like to thank the following. First, to our parents who have never failed to support us financially, emotionally, and physically. To our professor for guiding and giving us critical opinions to enhance our thesis. To Ms. Rilibet Negayo Javier for guiding and supervising our acute toxicity testing and as well our biological testing. And last, to our God, the Great Creator, for making all this possible. Thank you for listening. I am David Janti Jarillo, as principal investigator of the group, and here with me my co-investigators, we have Royce Ann Arizabal, Ms. Kathleen Armas, Ms. Jasmine Jane Del Rosario, Ms. Judith Hannah Malana, and Ms. Jessica Pamilor.
Thank you!